But dude, after my stream, if you're still awake, I don't mind helping you out with OBS and such, see if we can figure something out. Cause that's... that's fucking... And speaking of Ghost of Tsushima, chat, if you have a PS4 or PS5, fucking buy the game, dude. Do yourself a favor. It's one of the best games to come out in recent years. Yeah, nice head, dumbass. You can dip duck all you want, but it won't fucking save you, bitch. Redown? You mean like OBS?
Don't shoot.
It may not be a terrible idea to do a clean installation, because you seem to run into a lot of problems. With OBS. Make sure you back up like your overlay settings and all that, unless you're fine with doing it from scratch again. You know, make sure you back that stuff up. But it may not be a bad idea to like just wipe everything related to OBS and then do a fresh new install. That's typically what's recommended. Like, if you run into a lot of issues and they seem to just kind of happen out of nowhere, not typically fresh new installs are the way to go. And since you're using your GPU to encode, you know, make sure your GPU drivers are up to date, all that good shit. So Claire specifically runs faster when she's in caution. So you let that zombie bite you twice, that way you're just under the threshold. And you run fast. It's kind of why... I mean, for me anyways, I know some people think the other way around. But I feel like Claire... gives you less room for error, I suppose. Granted, there's a lot of healing items, but...
Focus.
Typically speaking, I think Leon is better. Well, actually, no, I take that back, because I don't know if Leon runs slower in caution. If Leon runs slower in caution, then yeah, never mind. Claire is easier. If Leon in caution is the same speed as when he's fine, Leon allows you more leeway for like getting hit and whatnot. While with Claire, if you want to get like competitive times, you have to stay hurt. So a couple of hits can kill you depending on what hit you. It also means that, you know, you're closer to going into danger and you run pretty slow when you're in danger, which is also not very good. That's weird, Capcom, but okay. Yeah, there's there's a few oddities in this game in terms of coding and whatnot. Just like the knife, I don't know if you're aware of it or not, but the damage of the knife is tied to the frame rate that you're getting. So the higher the frame rate, the more damage the knife does. That's why you see me use the knife a lot on the bosses. That's also why in the speedrun categories, there's a 60 FPS and a 120 FPS. That way you can just, you know, buy your way to victory by having the, you know, highest end components, getting a million FPS and just like one-shotting the boss, right? Ew! I still do that from time to time. Hit fucking right. You have yet to play this game, right, Martin? I really recommend doing RE1 Remake, RE2 Remake, and RE3 Remake. Good set of games. Gifted you the first one? Nice. You know, you like that isometric camera angle with the... Or, you like the fixed camera angles and tank controls, right? I would highly recommend checking out Tormented Souls. It is a horror survival game that came out 2.5 weeks ago. It's inspired by Silent Hill. It has, I don't remember if it has fixed camera angles or not, but it has, like, tank controls and all that. It's meant to be, a recreation of, like, old-school horror survival. But it's got a big titty anime waifu. Yeah, it's getting a lot of really good reviews. That's one of the games I'm gonna be playing this October. Fuck off! Yeah, it's getting... It has overwhelmingly positive reviews on Steam. Which, as of recently, doesn't happen often with new games. And I think it's only like 20 bucks. Pretty good. I recommend checking it out if you want that type of feel. I'm getting a lot of good RNG with this fucking liquor lately. But I'm fucking up everywhere else, so I mean... Give and take, give and take. Eleanor, behave. Devotion. It sounds so fucking familiar. I feel like I've played it before. Devotion. I think I have. Pretty sure I have. Made by a Red Candle Studio, right? Fucking went all over the place except for the medallion. Yeah, Devotion is a really good game. At least I really enjoyed it. Bitch, let me through, let me through, let me through, let me through, let me- Ah, you fucking- Yeah, I think it's Red Candle Studio. Do you have to buy it from their website? Red Candlestick. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. It's a great game. It's really fucking good. The other game that they have as well, because they have Devotion and then they have Detention. They're both really good games. If you haven't played Detention, I'd recommend it. They're both made by the same studio. They really love the D. For being a Taiwanese studio, they're good games. Typically, like, Taiwanese fucking horror games are some of the shittiest thing on the planet. Like, they're really fucking bad. But, yeah, no, their games are really good. Detention and Devotion both. What do you mean, gears? Oh, Gears of War. Isn't that only through the Xbox Game Pass, or is that actually on PC? Rather, can you get that through, like, Steam and shit? I thought it was only through the Game Pass. The Microsoft Store, yeah. I have super shitty experiences trying to play games through the Microsoft Store. I played Gears of War back on the 360 days. It was an alright game. All the other Gears of War after that are pretty much like clones of the first. I couldn't care less about them. They're probably still very fun, but I've already played through the first Gears of War. Don't care to play it again. Okay, I can't miss this fucking shot, dude. I can't do it! Pick up the thing. Fuck. Okay, we're good. Do need to grab the ammo here, though. What the fuck did I get caught on? I played 1 through 3 to experience with friends and played the Horde mode with them till I grew tired of it. Yeah, I don't know. They're very repetitive games as they go through the series. Which, I mean, hey. You know. If the formula fits, don't change, I guess. That seems to be true for a lot of fucking Xbox games, though. Like Halo? Halo's the same fucking shit all the way through. Like, it doesn't matter which game you play, they all play exactly the same. Well, I mean, I'm specifically referring to, exclusive by Microsoft. COD and Assassin's Creed, they're all cross-platform. Yeah, I mean, more or less the same. There's a lot of game franchises that are very repetitive. That don't really innovate. Dude, fuck's sake, delete the key, you fucking idiot. It's not that hard. Can't believe that out of all the fucking things that I have a problem with, deleting items is still one of them. I wish I was good at video games, dude. I really wish I was. Yeah, we do. Okay. Fuck. Oh, man. It's not even like each single mistake that makes me upset. It's the culmination of every single fucking mistake that I still make.
Thank you.
bad. Not bad. City pop is such a cool genre to listen to just like chill to.
You are gonna be so fucking sorry.
Go away! Help! Somebody, please!
You stupid bitch!
That's a dead end. Come on, big boy, come get me.
It's all over now. Doors locked. Where are you? Show yourself.
I know you're in here. The longer it takes me to find you, the worse it's gonna be. Gunnagy. What's up, Mr. Gunnagy? Wow, 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 wow. Banana. If there's one thing that I love out of Final Fantasies, they're fucking music. I love the Final Fantasy soundtracks. I like how it pauses the voice line when you enter the menus.
Hurry, hurry,
hurry. I'm coming, Sherry!
Run, Sherry, run!
Asshole.
What's up, buddy? I'm gonna try not to reload unless I need to, because I want to try to keep the... Well, I can at least reload once. I want to keep that one ammo there, that way if I pick up ammo in the sewers, assuming I don't need to reload again, it just throws it in there, I don't have to worry about moving it. You fucking slut of a dog. I thought he wasn't gonna jump for a second. Good thing I fucking nudged myself to the right there. What? Jesus!
It's gotta be the orphanage.
Fucking A, that dog stresses me out. Sub-27 sewers? That hasn't happened in a fucking minute. I mean, it's just barely under 27, but... It hasn't happened in a hot second. Music is very fitting. Yeah, Electro Swing seems to go with the speedruns pretty well. I'm getting grabbed, I'm getting grabbed, I'm getting grabbed. I'm not getting grabbed.
Hold on, Sherry.
Not where I wanted it. The game doesn't like listening to me, that's okay. 1930s chase music. Right. Thanks, Bozos. Yeah, you kinda... So there's two ways to get through that section. One is far more risky than the other, because it's all about timing, and you have to take a quick shot while stair skating. The other one is the one I just did. The one I just did obviously wastes a little bit more time, but it's safer. The other one is you hug the right side of the stairs as you're going down. I've done it a few times, but I haven't practiced it enough. Most of the time, I end up getting grabbed. But you hug the right side of the stairs. And then, as you're about halfway down, you take a quick shot on the dude on the right. And then you fucking cross your fingers, your balls, your toes, and pray to whatever god you believe in. And hug the right as you come out. The zombie on the left will lunge at you, but it should miss. That's the fastest way, but if you miss that shot, yeah, now you're wasting more time. Yeah, so I just decided to take the safer route until I practice more with it. And go with the double headshot instead. You kind of need to start... You kind of need to be able to land headshots on zombies. So in standard difficulty, a headshot always staggers the zombie. That's why every time I shoot the zombies, it's always headshots. Because it staggers them and it allows you to, you know, get by them. On hardcore, that's not the case. They can tank headshots. That's why you would have to aim at the leg instead. I'm getting grabbed here. Never mind. I'm too good. Yeah, Dave, if you're still here, you get to see the spark shot in action against the Jibolts. Unless I get lucky, dive down, dive down. Fucking A, dude, let's go! Didn't dive down, but started spewing little dudes. Great RNG. Let's go. Now I'm hoping to get some good RNG with the zombies over here on the way back as well. The chonky dude. Okay, good. Okay, that was decent.
My way. Well, it's got a good G2 as well.
I was fucking double tap too often on that one.
Nice. Don't fuck it up.
Nice, nice, nice.
Some time here, but
all right, that was a solid fucking G2. Let's go. Could have been better, definitely, but I'm not gonna complain about that one.
One of the better ones we've had in recent days.
Sometimes I fucking hate Discord. I got tagged somewhere. And I'm on the server where I got tagged, but it won't fucking...
I don't know what to do without you. Are you kidding me? I'm getting you treatment. Just hold on, Sherry. It's okay.
Psycho Pass is another really good fucking show.
Kinda hope the zombie over there grabs me so I can throw the knife out.
Mm-hmm.
No, 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 not right now. Don't grab me now, you fucking cocksmoker. Now you can grab me. Cause I feel... Show my everything to you. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. That shit ain't PG-13. Done with that cannoli. Fuck off, bitch. Lickers behave. Lickers behave. Good, good, good. Good, good. Might have been too early. Lucky, dude. Fucking lucky. He could have licked, he could have done any number of things and it would have hit me. Welcome back, Dr.
Lee. Damn. I should have packed my partner.
Oh, come on. Hug that seat tight. And we didn't get stunned. Nice, nice. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Nice. There was a zombie alive in there? I'm so glad he didn't fucking grab me. Okay, now we gotta deal with the ivies. Man. Dude, okay, where am I gonna fuck up? This is going too smoothly.
So much for the weed infestation.
Love this bad boy. Fucking ragdoll. Nice. And the ivies are good. Okay, on to G3 we go. Even if I don't do perfectly, and I do just as well as the last times, this is still gonna be a PB. But this has very strong potential of being sub 53. Kind of fucking relax, because every time I get excited, I fucking miss shots. It's pretty good so far, Pwn. It's pretty fucking good. That's not gonna break it. I fucking knew it, dude. I fucking knew it! I fucked up the entire fight. And I fucked up the knife swap too. God damn it, dude. Dude, we can still PB, I think, out of this. We can still PB. I can't believe it, dude. As soon as I fired that fucking spark shot, I knew it was gonna miss. Aw, dude, that feels bad. I should have honestly just shot the eye with the handgun. I think that would have been faster. Because when I miss the spark shot like that and I still do damage, it does a lot of damage. And I think one shot with the handgun after that would be enough to break it. So if that happens again, I need to just swap to the handgun and break the eye with that. It's faster. Fucking feels bad, because now we gotta run all the way fucking injured over here. We can heal up once we get down, but fuck. And we have a bunch of fucking unbroken knives and shit now, too.
Sherry,
lost 10 seconds. G3.
I wanna rush you, but we have to.
What? What? Who gives a shit, dude? Let me play the fucking game. Dude, Steam has been acting the fuck up for me. Earlier, I was having issues logging on to Steam because it kept telling me it couldn't connect to the server. Now it pauses the fucking game to tell me it can't connect to the Resident Evil servers? I don't give a shit. Let me play the fucking game. Yeah, we might as well keep the graphics low. I need to make room, though.
Leave your things until I get you out of this place.
Yeah, this is fucking awful. One bad G3, man. I see why people don't like grabbing the spark shot. Like, I know that getting the spark shot is a quote-unquote safe way to do G3, but I can see why some people say that using the spark shot is too stressful on G3. Because if you miss that last shot, it's just fucking goodbye, pretty much. I mean, like I said, I should have just used the handgun, popped the eye, and then, you know, went at it instead of using the spark shot. Using the spark shot after missing kind of created a bunch of different problems.
Of course. Stupid thing's locked. Hold on. Sherry, what are you? I think I can open it from the other side. Damn it, you're just gonna suck.
My idea is through the fucking roof, too. I might as well just fucking speedrun this game on hardcore, dude.
Sherry, you hanging in there? I'm right behind you. Atta girl. I think we're almost out of here.
Come on. Give me a solid G4, dude. If I can get a knife kill on G4, we sub 53. Guaranteed, because my G4 is fucking terrible. That was a late nade. Fuck, that went good too. That was good too, dude. That was a good knife. He went up right away. Bullshit. Bullshit. This still a PB? Is this still a PB? Hey, let's go! 20 second PB, dude. Well, 20 seconds. Fucking math is difficult. What is that? Fuck, dude. Words are difficult. 53-38. 53-53. Math is hard. Five. That's a 15 second PB. We'll take it. We'll fucking take it. Yep, 53-38. Let's fucking go. Ah, dude.